Hey everyone, Commander Josh Hawkins here, and welcome back to the live stream. We're playing Elite Dangerous, and what are we doing? Well, I'm going to show you how we can make 100 million credits. I'm not saying it's going to be easy. I'm just saying you can make 100 million credits with a new mission that's been introduced with the new patch. So we got patch 2.2.03 is out today, and with that, many changes have come to the game. We might take a quick look at some of the major changes that are in the game right now, but one of the big things that came out along with it was a mission that allows you to make 100 million credits. So, yeah, a little clickbaity title, but guess what? You could still make 100 million credits, so let's take a look at what we need to do for that. Let me get my game started over here. Hey, what's up, guys? I see a whole bunch of people in the chat. I don't have my pop-up chat up here, so just give me 1 second. I'll get my pop-up up, and then we could say hello. Let me sleep, you Thargoids. Morpheo, there's no Thargoids today. It's just little old Josh and the alien ruins. Okay, let's get the pop-up up. The pop-up up. I need the pop-up up, please. Someone give me the pop-up up. There we go. Pop-up is up. And live stream is up. Elite Dangerous is up. Who do we got in here? Well, I know General Ghost is in here. And Valdar, Schmonger Ops, DK, Zexion, Almasi. Who else we got? Toru, Wow, Matthew Kennedy. Valeriano Martino, 195th Moses, Commander Leon, Morpheo Atreides, Frogster, Hack Robert Renato, Cookie Rebel. What's up, Cookie Rebel? So, hey, Cookie Rebel, you got to let me know if you found anything over there. Haven't checked the bro bar yet. Dakota Shea, Commander Kuhad, DH397, Jacob Lejbol. I think I always mispronounce that. Top Blazer, Frito Mayer, Commander Malik, Kylo Ren. Kylo Ren's here? OX07AF. Kamax Tilly. The Right Nut. Jeffrey Thomas. Hey, Right Nut, where's Left Nut? Ikea, Pedro Lukin, and Mark Zarkzewski. Zakarzewski. How's it going, everyone? Happy Tuesday. Yeah, it's Tuesday. Well, Wednesday for some of you. I don't know if it's Thursday yet anywhere, but happy everything. And we're going to go in. We're going to show you how to do this. And I'm sure that we'll get a little bit of help from all of y'all because we have to go over to the ruins. We got to get a mission and hopefully make some money. I don't think it's going to happen today. From everything that I've heard, it's a mission that's going to take a little bit of time to actually get to. Well, to completion at least, but 100 million credits is for real. It's not stackable. I already saw that in the chat. It is a single one-time deal kind of thing, and anyone who wants to join me is certainly welcome to do so in the game. I'm loading up into my private group, so feel free to jump in there and wing up while we go ahead and try to make some money. Patch notes. I'm gonna bring up the patch notes here, and we could talk about that a little bit too while we make 100 million credits. Let's see where my patch notes are. Oh, and I have a couple of images I'm gonna share once we get over there. Left Nut has no has no net right now. All right, fair enough. It's turned Wednesday. Yeah, happy Tuesday for me and happy Wednesday for you. Howdy, Josh. Oh, I'm still carrying this UA. You know what? Let's get rid of this damn thing. Where's Robert McLeod? You want a UA back? I owe you a UA. But I stole this one from Shibuka because he didn't mark it as jettison. Oh, I got to turn my cargo hatch back on. Let's see. Cargo hatch back on. Yes. And let's get rid of this UA because I don't necessarily want to. Well, you know what? We'll carry it around until we get to the alien artifact. The alien. Until we get to the alien ruins. And maybe we'll get interdicted on the way over there by another alien. Wouldn't that be cool? General Ghost is in my wing. And my dogs are barking in the background. And I just ate a can of sardines. So good thing you guys can't smell my breath, because it smells like a bucket of sardines right now. Wednesday, almost lunchtime, Malik. Jesus. You're like halfway through the day already. Well, let me know how tomorrow is, because I'm barely there yet. Commander Rogue says he's on his way to Ifat, so I won't be seeing the runes for a while. Yeah, that's right. Some people are headed over to the Ifat system. Cookie Rebel was over there this morning. Is it Thursday somewhere? No, I don't think it is, James. I don't think it's Thursday quite yet. Yeah, so the whole EFOTS thing, as you guys are probably seeing in the chat right now, with the patch, one of the systems in the EFOTS system, maybe Cookie Rebel can tell us what exactly that system was, since I don't have it up here right now. But they made it so that one of the systems where commanders were crashing, trying to go into orbit, and this is the Formidine Rift area of space. Okay, General Ghost, I'll get moving in a second. Stop rushing me. We have a whole live stream to do this. From what I understand, we're not going to finish it today anyhow, but we're going to try. So yeah, one of those systems is, it was crashing. People made their way out there, and they were trying to get into orbit around the planet, and it kept crashing. And the suspicion was maybe that one planet, there it is right there. Thank you, Cookie Rebel. EFOTS LZ-HB10-0. Might have had something related to the Formidine Rift, which, if you don't already know, and I'll go ahead and just plot a course back to Ram Tah. If you don't already know, the Formidine Rift is kind of an area of space that's supposed to contain some type of mystery that is supposedly been in the game for the whole time. Oh, wait a second. It's not Ram Tah that I need to go to. That's the name of the guy that I got to go get this from. What's the system that I need to go to where Ram Tah is located? I had it up on my screen. I can pull it up here again, but maybe if someone could just put that in the chat, that would be very helpful. Let's see. Let's go to my folder where I've got it saved and see if I could find it before you guys do. Let's see how quick I am. Ram Tah, Ram Tah, Ram Tah. Oh, darn it. I didn't save the darn image. Nope, I'll have to rely on you guys. Tell me where it is, folks. This is why I have you guys. Call me Josh Newkins. I am not the Noomkins. I am the Josh Boskins. Yeah, Josh Boskins. I like that one. Guten Abend, Commander. Felis Doc in Meene. Is that where I'm going? Okay, Felis Doc. Let's head over there. Felis Doc. No, that's not Felis Doc. Let's try that again. Apparently there's more than one Felis Doc. There we go. 343 light years. Maybe we'll get an interdiction or a hyperdiction along the way. Let's start jumping, and we'll talk about the Formidine Rift while we're doing that. Let me just turn some game sounds up, because they're really quiet from the other day. And there we go. And some background music for ambience. Okay, I think we're good to go. Astra, can you hear me?
Yes, awaiting orders.
We've got Astra going. Make the jump. Or don't. Don't make the jump. Why don't you want to make the jump? Why don't you ever listen to me, you damn AI? All these AI. Let's repair my cockpit. All right, so Formidine Rift, for those of you who don't know, is, as I was saying, the sort of secret that's been in the game since the very beginning. We don't know what exactly is there. Drew Wagar has written it into his books. It's supposed to be, if I recall correctly in the lore, maybe you guys in the chat can correct me if I'm missing. Yeah, I know, Astrothought. If I'm missing any of the details on this, this is just sort of like a quick run-through of it. So the Formidine Rift was supposed to be an area of space that contains something of great power, possibly a portal to another galaxy or dimension or something like that. And we don't know where it is. It could be in space, could be on a planet. Apparently it's been in the game since the very beginning, so my suspicion was that whatever this portal or whatever it's supposed to be in the Formidine Rift is, wouldn't be on a planet's surface. It would be in space, and many commanders have been hunting for it. There's forum posts about it, threads that are pages and pages and pages long, and cannons look for it. I've spent a considerable amount of time talking to Shibuka with our tinfoil hats, investigating that as well, and trying to solve some mysteries that came into the game quite some time ago. Nobody's found anything. So, as of late, there was a crash when you try to descend into orbit around one particular planet in the Forbidden Rift area. Commanders were crashing, and with the new patch, apparently they named this one specific planet and they say that it's fixed. There's no longer crashing on that planet. So why were commanders crashing around that one particular planet? Well, the suspicion, of course, was that maybe whatever it was that's hidden is hidden on that planet, similar to how the alien runes were found. Again, I don't think that's the case because apparently this has been in the game since the very beginning, so unless they added something in or maybe they changed it or moved locations of it down to a planet surface with horizons, I don't think it is the same thing that was there. Could be something new, could be a clue for the whole Forbidden Rift mystery, but we don't know. Either way, I know Cookie Rebel went out there and he spent some time around the planet today, and I guess he didn't find anything, because I think, Cookie, if I'm not mistaken, you are rushing your way back now to participate in this 100 million credit mission, right? If I'm not mistaken. Good night, Jacob Lebjbol. Already taken off. Well, thanks for jumping in. Unless you're saying good night as in, like, good night. Like some people say good morning or good evening. We have a few jumps to go here before we get back to Saul. Let's see, how long? 10 jumps before I get to Meene, and then I'll grab the mission, and then I will head over to the ruins, and we'll see if we could start unlocking this. This mission, from what I understand, thanks to General Ghost, who, maybe I should drag him into the channel and have him describe it to you, because I don't know that much about it. All I know right now is that you grab a mission from Ram Tah in the Meene system, where I'm heading, and it sends you back to the runes to gather data from the obelisks or from the data nodes that are there. Now, I was fortunate enough to be one of the first people on site of the alien runes, and I got to scan as many as I could. And at the time, you were getting like alpha and beta and gamma and delta. The data was from the runes. It didn't really seem to do much at the time. And then, if I recall correctly, there was a CG or a mission or something like that where a particular NPC was just asking for data to be turned in, and that, of course, was to help to decipher what all that information meant. From what I understand of this particular mission, and I haven't picked it up yet, so I don't know exactly, is that you need to scan the data nodes while holding one of the artifacts or something like that. Like, there's different artifacts around the alien runes as well. You have like obelisks and, or not the, well, yeah, there's obelisks, but there's like orb, there's casket, there's all these different things, totems, and I believe you have to hold a particular one or two of those in your cargo hold on your SRV while you're scanning the data nodes, the obelisks or whatnot. And there's quite a few different combinations, and some people have said that it's random, other people have said that it's not random, so we're going to spend a little bit of time and figure this all out so that you guys can all go and do the same thing. Because who doesn't want 100 million credits, right? I mean, like, holy crap, 100 million credits? Yeah, sure, General Ghost, give me one sec. Let me drag you down to wherever I am. Where am I? I'm not even in there. We'll drag you down. Here we go. Dragging down General Ghost. Hey, General Ghost. How you doing?
Hello.
Hello. So,
stream.
Did I get it right?
Kind of sort. Which part? If it's random or not random?
Yeah, part? The whole. Well, I mean, the general idea of how this mission works.
Well, yeah, generally you got it right, but from our research here in the broadcast, it kind of seems like you get assigned the random parts of the research to random combinations. Because, wait, can I copy for you in the pro bar?
Yes.
Not the pro bar, I send you in private.
Yeah, send me in a private.
Our findings so far there.
Absolutely. And I'm going to share a couple of images that I have as well here. One of the images is the one that you shared earlier in the bro bar. And then there is another one that I have. What's this other one? Oh, this is just how to find the runes. This is actually from Radio Sidewinder, which is also very handy. If you do want to get down there, it helps to know how to actually get to it. So I'll show everyone how to do that as well. Once I pick up the mission, before we actually go over to the runes, I'll show people what the location of the runes is, and then we'll show that other graphic that you have, the infographic that shows sort of like where the different data nodes are located. I don't know if that one's actually still up to date.
It's up to date.
It is up to date. Okay, excellent.
Hey, Turgeon.
Hello.
Turgeon, how you doing?
I'm pottering about the ruins at the moment.
You are also doing the 100 million credit...
I am.
Ah.
Well. They've changed it. Someone's been in here and dusted them since the time.
Well, I'm glad that they're keeping them clean for us, because I don't like dust. I'm allergic, so... Well, look at this.
Oh, yeah, and one more thing, Josh. It seems that Frontier has valid tested this, and it seems everything is a bit unstable right now. What the fuck? Hostile. Oh, Cookie Rebel. He's attacking me with this fighter.
Cookie Rebel, and you're. Wow, Cookie Rebel, you made it back already? How many light years did you travel today?
He blew himself up just to be here.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that's probably what I would have done too, because, I mean, what? Otherwise. He traveled, what, 7,500 light-years out there, I think it was?
Yeah, that's pretty far away.
Sorry, I have to stop and look at this planet, because I zipped past it real quick, and it kind of caught my eye, because it has a big splotch on it here. External camera. Let's take a look at that. It's kind of a cool-looking planet. Looks like it has a giant hole in it. It's either a massive crater, or a giant bird took a dump on that thing.
A giant hawk.
I think this is where the Hawkins are born. They hatch out of this planet. That's what it is. That's a Hawkins egg right there.
It's a really interesting looking planet.
It is.
It's like...
That's no planet.
That should be an ocean. Maybe that's like an ocean or something that dried up.
That's what it kind of looks like, right? It looks like, you know, if I had to take a guess, and I mean, I know that a lot of these planets are generated rather randomly, but if I had to take a guess, because you see the planet is rather molten, and it's very, very close to the star, too. I mean, only a few light seconds away. So it's probably a very hot surface temperature. It looks to me like there must have been a massive impact right in the middle of that. And then because the planet itself is quite molten, the hot liquid magma poured out and filled in that giant crater right over there. External camera. Because that is one hell of a magma crater. This is one of the planets that I cannot wait to be able to land on and just go scoot around in my SRV.
It would be very interesting.
Oh, magma oceans. So purdy.
So, I think this type of planet you might need a bit of heat protection.
Maybe, possibly. That's where the different SRV is going to... Yeah, well, you know, eventually we know that they're going to be introducing different types of SRVs at some point or another, and...
The current one is kind of made out of tinfoil paper.
You're telling me, man. You bump one tiny little pebble and you lose 10% of your hull. Like, holy crap.
You bump a dust particle and you lose 2% of your hull.
Dakota Shea says, Unicron! Terraformer says, it's Thargoid poop. Yeah, it very well could be. It's a giant Thargoid poop. I have a feeling we're not going to get hyperdicted on the way back, because we are well out of the UA shell.
It's really toned down.
Yeah, it did tone down. But Ed Lewis got interdicted on his live stream earlier today, from what I understand, so he got very lucky.
I mean, they are developers. That's not that hard to pull off.
Ed's not a dev, is he? No, he's the galactic intern. He's kind of like their PR person, so I don't think...
They can make him get interdicted.
I suppose they could. But if he's playing on the live server, can they? Because I'd think that the live server... I mean, I don't know. I'm sure they they have some way of doing it, but I'd think that on the live server it's not like they can just like press a button, make him get hyperdicted. I still think he was playing recorded footage though, because his hands were not on any joystick or keyboard, and I was literally watching him like flying around and opening Galaxy Map, and his hands are like this, like Galaxy Map's opening, he's selecting new things.
Entirely possible, it didn't touch it for.
Yeah.
True. Also, they could possibly do it because there was no patch on the 5th of, like, when the aliens came, you know?
Yeah, well, there was no patch. For that, they just flipped a switch, obviously. But
so they could just summon an alien encounter to him, too. I don't think it's entirely impossible.
It is entirely possible.
So yeah, once you look at our data, it can be seen that there are a lot of duplicates, but with completely different combinations of items. I sent it to you already.
Okay, I'm gonna take a look at all the stuff in the bro bar and pull up the images as soon as I get to the mission giver, which
send
is
you in private.
Okay, and that is Ram Tah. In the Meene system, M-E-E-N-E, for those of you who do want to go ahead and grab the mission and head over to the ruins. The Meene? Meene.
Yeah.
In the Meene system. I don't think it would be Meene. It's the Meene. Meene. It's not Meene. It's the Nicey system.
Technically, you didn't grab the mission. You just look at the station and he forces you into the mission.
Oh, he just... Oh, right, before you go there, and I'm going to have to do this as well just to make sure, this is what the bros were telling me earlier, is you need to make sure that you don't have any data on you already. So
yeah, I'm going to dump my data too.
You need to...
Yeah, and currently, the very well-tested beta turned out to crash constantly at the ruin site, so that might be a thing to prepare for.
Okay, well,
also,
I am...
sometimes they don't give data or anything to scan the obelisks, so yeah.
Okay.
We have our fair share of problems. Somiva refuses to give you any data, so once Frontier fixes this, I have to do a second run through of the entire ruins with every single combination again.
Well, I have quite a few of these already. I have Pattern Gamma, Obelisk Data, I have 9 of those, I have Pattern Epsilon.
Yeah, but you're not getting those, you're getting, like, lore, research data.
Well,
sends you to your inbox.
These are the ones that I have to delete, right?
Yeah.
Okay, that's...
Because those are just, right now, completely useless.
They are useless. It's unfortunate that you had a lot of useless stuff. I mean, that stuff was only good for the CG that they had going on. But otherwise, completely and utterly useless. Did that not delete? Discard. Oh. Oh, you've got to be kidding me. Oh, okay, never mind. There we go. Have an option. I was like discarding one at a time. I didn't realize it wouldn't just discard the whole batch. Okay, discard
yes.
All. Discard
okay,
all.
Systems.
Discard all. Discard all. Now, let me just make sure I don't have anything else. Abnormal compact emissions data, no. Atypical disrupted...
You should keep those, though.
Oh, I'm keeping all of this stuff. Classified scan fragment, decoded emission data. I'm just trying to figure out what stuff actually came from the ruins.
It's called, like, Gamma scan, alpha, beta, gamma, delta scan.
Yeah, so it was only those ones, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So I think everything else is...
And if you have the alien scan, I think you should keep those from the alien encounters.
Oh, the unknown ship signature, I'm totally keeping that. And the unknown wake data, I am absolutely keeping those. I am not getting rid of those, not in a million years. For now. I mean, until they request it for some type of CG.
Yeah. Federation or Imperium or maybe a third party.
That's it.
At the same time.
Someone's asking, but do you have to have him unlocked? No, Terra Firma, from what I understand, you do not need to have him unlocked. That was actually a concern of mine.
Luckily.
Well, like General Ghost was just saying, all you have to do is kind of land at any station in the Meene or Meene or whatever, Meene system, and they'll just force it right on you. You get
You have no choice just but to accept.
Yeah. Just get your KY ready, because you have no choice. They forced the mission right on you.
And it's a 1 month long mission, so you have time to do it.
Yes, it's, 4 weeks total? 3 weeks, 7 days, and...
3 weeks and 6 days and 15 hours for me now. So,
you got...
4 months.
You got lots of time. Because from what I understand, you guys already did a little bit of math and worked out that it's, what, like 2,700 different possible combinations to get all the pages that you need for this?
Yes, and some doesn't give you anything. Some give you 3 or 4 of the required data. And there are 100. The most logical thing is that you have 100 million and 100 million credits as mission complete bonus, so I think the full reward should be around like 81 million, what we would say, because the Dota types that we have, Dota technology, historical, language and biological Dota, and they add up like the complete number to 81. So there are 81 different like lore splits, what I don't know how to say it. And they don't make a lot of sense without each other.
I did read a couple of them. I think they're pretty funny.
The ones I posted.
Yeah, the ones you posted earlier. Do you want to just... I'm going to read it when I get to the talk, because I thought it was hilarious. The one that you posted earlier, I swear to God, it made it sound like the alien runes are just like a big alien porn data collection site.
Yeah. Biological number 9.
Number 9. Yeah, post that one in the bro bar or send it to me in a PM so I can read that one out loud. That was pretty funny.
Here, let me get it.
Okay, while you get that, I'm going to pull in on Felice Doc. And yes, someone was asking in the chat if it is Felice Doc. So yes, it is Felice Doc. The mini-me system.
Number 9. There you go.
Okay, thank you. I'll go ahead and read that out in just a sec here while I... Right after I land at Felice Doc.
Some of the others are interesting, too. You could make an entire episode out of reading up all these.
I probably could. Well, if you want to post them all, I'll read them all. I mean, we're going to be getting some of these, so maybe this will be
okay,
a spoiler
alert.
Okay, you
know what? Let me get my Dropbox up and pile them into a file and send it to you.
Yeah, send it over, and then I'll see which ones I'm missing as we collect them as we go around. I'm assuming...
And... Yeah, I'm going to document what you find, too, because I need the documentation of what we have yet.
Sure.
And and screenshot every single one of the data if you can, Josh. We're going to research.
You want me to screenshot them? I can do that. I can go ahead and screenshot them.
Okay.
Well, if you're in the stream with me while I'm getting them, you'll just tell me if it's ones that you have already, and if it's not, then I'll screenshot them. If you already have them, you probably already have a screenshot anyhow, so...
Yeah. It's entirely possible to get duplicates.
Oh, it is? You can get dupes too? Wonderful!
But between two players, I mean, me and Commander Serial or Ney,
deploy landing
gear. Like, I think 3 or 4 of the same ones, let me check. Yeah, we got three of the... We got 11 in total, but he got 6, I got 9, now 10. And he got 3 of them, the same as I do, just with different combinations. So, for example, for me, the casket plus orb equaled a Dota Tech, the 7th out of the 20. And for him, relic plus casket equaled the same like research out of a different obelisk.
That's weird. I wonder why they would have that. Well, that's what it comes back down to, what we were saying before. Random number generation. So, first thing I need to do is I got to get myself an SRV, because I don't have one in here.
That's an important part.
Yeah, kind of important, I'd say, right? I guess I can get rid of the field maintenance unit, since we're not doing that anymore. And we'll get...
You should... Did you sell the... UA?
I jettisoned it, yeah.
Jettisoned it. Who needs it?
Well, it was also stolen, so I couldn't really do much with it.
Well, you are in the anarchy system.
There we go. Get myself a couple SRVs. Buying options. Purchase. Two SRVs ought to do, just in case I accidentally hit a particle of dust on the way over to my data scans and explode.
I mean, you can just settle down in the middle of the ruins, and if you get damaged, you can always just go into the ship and come out.
And look at this. Is this... Oh no, this isn't the extra slot, is it? So one of the things that they added in with the patch...
The extra slot is in... Core.
It's in core
systems, and it's on the bottom.
Okay, maybe not on this one here. Five fuel tank.
There you go. I sent link for you in private.
I guess the ASP didn't get.
Yeah,
any...
the ASP is not a combat ship; it's an exploration ship.
Yeah, that's
but
true.
The Corvette.
Yes.
Has two
so why did they give one to the Anaconda?
Because it's a multi-purpose ship.
By the way, one of the other things
more
I read...
More internet, by the way. That's why I disappeared. I think they're funnying about with my local exchange, so I disappeared for a few minutes.
Oh, okay. Well, the...
Not that you noticed.
Well, no. Oh, welcome back. You were gone.
Oh, there's that guy there.
The Viper Mark III got a... what did they do? They reduced the hull mass by 10 tons, so... It's
got a new lightweight frame, as the patch notes said.
Lightweight frame, which is awesome. The Viper is a great little combat ship. I mean, especially for people that are starting out and want to get into combat. Yeah. I've had a lot of people ask me, like, well, what ship should I buy? And people tend to go for the Cobra, which, I mean, sure, Cobra is great, too. I never liked it. I'm not a fan of the Cobra. Never was, never will be. Viper... All the way. Best combat ship for beginners. Now that it's a little lighter, I'm assuming that's going to increase its top speed.
Better jump range, too.
Better jump range. And it has an extra military slot as well, which means that when you do put that extra, like hull reinforcement kit on it...
You can put in the military slot hull reinforcement, modular reinforcement, and shield cell banks.
Beautiful. Can't wait to check that out on my Vulture, because if I'm not mistaken, they gave the Vulture an extra size 5 slot, if I'm not mistaken.
Well, it's...
Yeah, they did, yeah.
It's the biggest combat ship, technically. Oh, that's the Corvette.
I can't wait. Vulture is my favorite by far. Let me go ahead, and I'm just going to pull up the chat here while I show off a couple of these images that I wanted to show here real quick. So, images... Let's see, what's this?
Also, the rebooting thing is now in, which is amazing.
What's that?
When you reboot, you get 50% of your shield back, jump start. Oh, the shields when you reboot.
Nice.
For, like, I think, combat zones, it's amazing. Just go out a few kilometers, reboot, and you have 50% shield back.
Yeah, well, that was only 50%. Okay, I thought it was 100%.
Would be way too powerful.
Yeah, in the beta, that's what it was. It was, I think it was full restart of your shields. If I remember correctly, I could be remembering wrong. It was a few weeks ago I was playing it. Okay, so here's image number one. If you want to grab a screenshot of that, or if you're not in our Discord, hey, Turgeon, I don't know if you could... you're in chat. Perfect. Would you mind linking our Discord link there for anyone who wants to join in? If you haven't already joined our Discord...
In the description.
Is it? Oh, yes, of course. I think the link in the description should be permanent, so you can always look at the link in the description of the video and join our Discord. This image, I believe, is in the announcements. I'm just going to double-check that. It is, right?
We got Turgeon to put it in announcements.
Yeah, so... That image is in the announcements, and this just shows you the overview of the alien runes, and it shows you which one of the data points are actually active and scannable. So you can always use this as a guide for
and
where you want to go.
Categorize where you get the scans from, like the research, if you do that.
And it also shows...
So, Ghost, what happened to the totem then?
Oh. I can't find one.
Can't find the totem.
No, it used to be, well, on that image, it was down the bottom left, wasn't it?
Yeah, but they completely changed.
But they've moved all the filing cabinets now. They've shuffled them all around, so it's not where it was, and I haven't found it yet.
I can't find one either.
And then here, this is the other image. This is the image from Radio Sidewinder on how to actually find the alien runes, which is what we're going to be using once we head over there in order to actually locate them.
I mean, you can just follow my wing beacon.
Well, I'm going to use your wing beacon, but everyone else who wants to get there is going to have to figure out how to get there. If you use this diagram, it's actually really easy to find it. You don't have to spend the hours scouring the planet for some kind of weird form on the ground like we did originally.
Well, technically you didn't need it either, because now it shows the coordinates and the compass in orbit.
Oh, so, well, okay. Yeah. So, even better. Still helpful. I'm a visual guy.
Of course, you still can't put, like, bookmarks on the planet.
Not yet. Unless you have that that Commander's app that I think is fantastic. I don't know if it's finished yet. I got to look into that and follow up and see if he's finished it up. Anyone got links for the images? Yeah, Toru Wow, all you got to do is join our Discord, which Turgeon has very kindly linked for you, just a few comments up. Click on that, join in our Discord, and you'll be able to find the images there. The 100 million mission is to get newer players into a capable combat ship in preparation for the human/alien fleet battles. Probably a very sound theory, Anarchy Empire. If I had to take a guess, I'd say you're very, very well. You're right on the right track for sure. And I've seen a lot of people saying they're going to.
For the peace contract.
The reason is that they like having Forbes articles, so they want to get as many people as possible out here. And who can blame them?
Oh, well, I think the alien runes has already been done. I'm pretty sure we did that already.
Yeah, but now we're doing it again.
We are doing it again. It's bringing people back there. I think what it's doing is it's kind of bringing attention away from the fact that, hey, wait a second, there haven't been very many hype predictions. And guess what? There's no new alien ships yet, and the patch is out, which is just bothering me that nothing new happened immediately, but...
Well, the only new thing that I can see is that Ram Tah is explicitly calling the makers of these ruins guardians.
Yes, they are.
Explicitly.
And from the rather than just people guessing, we already have, we can determine that they are not the Targoids. Hmm. Because they are bisexual, gendered, humanoid-like.
Yeah.
Sorry, you're going to see my little stream thing pop up here for one sec. Just got to turn this on. I forgot to turn on the eagle, the screaming hawk.
Okay.
Also, they are eco warriors from few of the already found research found by us. That they are kind of like all about the environment and then drive themselves into extinction by a biological weapon. Nori?
Yeah.
All right, well, I'm going to go ahead and read a couple of these now. Let's see, where did you put those?
You sent
me a Dropbox, right?
Okay. And it's in a RAR file.
Let's take... Oh, it's a RAR file? Jeez.
Yeah, because you can't upload a file.
Okay, I can't be bothered with all of that right now. When I'm streaming, I have like literally like 7 windows open already, and it's too complicated. We'll just go out there. We'll read some of them as we discover them. So,
and you can always read the one I sent out, the... the biological one.
Where is that one? Is it in private message?
No, it's in the bro bar.
Oh, it's in the bro bar. Okay, let me go to the bro bar, because I did want to read that one. Here we go. Okay.
Rogue 949, hashtag not shoot the hawk. Shoot the hawk. Torjan, we need to shoot the hawk.
Okay,
I have a new one.
No, this isn't the one.
Go on, try this one.
No. Crush that hawk.
That's proper
nasty. It's a new one.
Yeah, I knocked one up for you there.
That's great. No, this isn't the one that I wanted, General Ghost. I wanted the one that talks about how they have two distinct sexes.
I don't know where that is. Might be like in the upper atmosphere of the chat right now.
Oh gosh.
Let me scroll back up.
Okay, well, don't bother. Don't bother. It's okay. We'll find it. I just wanted to read it because I thought it was pretty funny.
This one is funny too, actually. Or more educational. But interesting.
Shibuka just messaged me, said agricultural sites look like they're still bugged. I'm not sure which agricultural sites he was talking about.
It was the one at the EFOTS system that they, you know, you were supposed to be able to drop out at and have a look at.
I thought Cookie Rebel was there already today. He didn't mention anything about it being bugged out or anything.
It doesn't crash. You don't crash when you go to it. But I don't think there's anything there to find. That's the problem.
Okay. By the way, I'm landed at Felice Dock, and nobody has forced any missions on me quite yet. So
check your messages.
Messages.
Check
your
my
emails.
Messages.
Top left.
Yeah, emails.
Decoding the ancient runes. There it is.
Yeah, that's it.
There you go.
Okay, so here it is, folks.
You know, decoding. They don't even give you a choice. He's that desperate and pushy. Is Ram Tah. He just goes, "Oi, you."
All right. Let's do it. I'm going to read this out.
Can I repeat this mission? No, you can't.
Your context. All right.
I'm going to read out the mission. So here it is. Decoding the ancient runes from Ram Tah. Commander Jay Hawkins, I have an exciting opportunity to offer you. My research into the alien runes has yielded results of a sort. I have developed a way to decode the data from the ancient sites. Hey, that's awesome. Although I cannot specify the various combinations of objects and data types needed, my decoding system should help decipher the ancient data. The key is using the ancient objects with active obelisks to unlock it. I've taken the liberty of uploading my decoding software to your ship systems. Hey. No. I've already had things uploaded to my ship.
I know. He just forces the mission on you. Thanks.
I did not give you permission to upload anything into my ship. How do I know what you've put in my ship yet?
You have just violated my ship, sir.
Seriously.
I mean, he didn't say, but it's possibly true. If you deny the mission, your ship will explode.
Where's the deny mission button? He doesn't even give you one.
Yeah. No, there is none.
Abandon, yeah.
Oh, here, Turgeon, we'll get that new audio clip ready. League of Bellins has joined the Hawk Vlog.
All right. Well, I have another one for you just for that.
Oh, okay.
Welcome. And now, the Thargoids will eat your brains. Nom nom.
That was Minion.
That was interesting.
That was Minion, wasn't it? You recorded your dog.
There might be some dog in there.
There might be some dog. It sounded like a little growling poochie. I know the sound of little growling dogs. I have two of them. Anyhow, let me finish reading the description. He says, oh, okay, so after he forces his mission onto me and uploads software to my ship without my permission, unfortunately, the ancient technology adapts to the cipher after a few weeks, so our task is time critical. Please explore as many ancient sites as you can find. If you find all the data entries, there will be a bonus in it for you. Okay, well, that's wonderful. So now is it uploaded into my mission logs? Is that it? I can see it under transactions, decoding the ancient runes. Okay, so he says this exact same thing. Rewards mission completion bonus. There it is, folks. 100 million credits.
If you get all the 81 of them.
And you also get rewards for just collecting every
one
single one.
Of the like research you get 1 million for that, and you get 100 million credits extra if you find them all.
Oh,
so it's basically Pokemon.
So it's not even 100 million credits, it's like 181 million credits then.
Yeah,
well,
oh, that's amazing. So that's like buying your Anaconda and having a little bit of insurance for it. Beautiful.
You know, where's this guy getting the money from? Worries me.
Well, yeah, it's a good question. Well, apparently he's getting it from somewhere. But I was looking at Reddit. I was looking at the forums, and I saw a lot of, oh, all right, I'm going to go buy in my first Anaconda. I'm like, oh, you have no idea how bad of an idea that is. Like, go buy an Anaconda with the only money that you have, and then you'll be back in a Sidewinder in 10 minutes.
Yep.
That's kind of
people don't realize that when you buy an Anaconda, you have another $200 million investment, 200 million credits investment to make that thing actually worthwhile flying. Because I think just the frameshift drive alone is like $100 million on that thing.
I think you need like three anacondas worth to make one worth flying, I think, in terms of cash.
It's crazy.
If you could buy three anacondas, then you can buy one.
Yeah, exactly.
I needed around $600 million to make my anaconda worthwhile to use. And engineers.
Anarchy Empire says, oh my god, hey, some guy said he has a mission from the Federation to deliver a package to a base in some random planet beyond the center. He says it says that the base is part of the reserve fleet? Huh. Anarchy Empire, cite where you got that information from? Is that from Reddit? Is that from the forums? Or is it just rumor from Reddit? It's very interesting.
If it's from Reddit, I would doubt it.
I also saw a screenshot of some guy who was like 20,000 light years away from the bubble, and he found an ASP, like a system defense ship sitting on the surface of a random ice planet. So I don't know if that was just a random bug, or it did say system defense. Usually system defense only spawn in systems that actually have something in them. I thought that was kind of interesting. Doc Schmuckper says, come this mission by itself. Yes, it does come by itself. You don't have to necessarily be at Felice Dock, from what I understand. You could be at any station in the Meene system, which you can see here, Meene, M-E-E-N-E. You just go ahead and you land at any of those systems and check your messages, and you should have that mission right away. Yeah, I do agree. Game trials, community goals are much easier, and you can get a considerable amount of money from participating in those. But if you realize that once you get to the ruins, there's not much to do other than just drive around and scan the stuff. It's not really that complicated. You just have to spend some time there. And I think it's really cool too, because a lot of people haven't seen the ruins for themselves, and this will give you the opportunity to go and look at them. Now, you're going to see them on the live stream, obviously. You're going to get a chance to see them here. You can also watch them on my video. I've got a couple of videos on the ruins already uploaded on my YouTube channel if you want to look back there and check those out. Some very detailed up close looks. I mean, you might get there, or you might not have the time to go check out the ruins. If you want to see like really cool detailed looks of it, with basically showing off everything, I do have a really cool video up on the YouTube channel that you can check out that shows everything off. So you can always go do that. But hey, if you want to make some money and
changed.
What's that?
No, it's basically completely new.
What, the ruins?
Almost everything is displaced.
The stones the same as it was. Yeah. But they've moved all the filing cabinets around.
What? That's ridiculous.
Yeah. It's completely changed over.
That's ridiculous.
Came in the office when we weren't looking and moved everything around, you know? Huh. Where's my desk? Who's moved my desk? That's what's going on.
Okay, so we're going to the Sinuf XR-H. Sinufi? I don't know how to pronounce it. It's one of those weird names. Sinuf.
Scientific name. Get it right.
XR-. Sinuf. Sinuf?
Sinuf.
Hey, how come I'm in the wrong spot here? Where am I? This is the wrong sector. No, that's Pleiades. You're there already, aren't you?
Just full of the gigantic wing thingy that's shown on the system. Above the system.
Sinuf XR-HD11-102. That's where we're going. It's 239 light years from Sol, or from the bubble, or never mind. From Meene. It's 239 light years from Meene. How far that is from Sol, I have no freaking clue. Okay. Let's launch and start heading over there. Actually, let me just make sure I've got everything I need. I've got my SRVs, right? I've repaired. I've got everything else that I need, and I'm pretty sure that's it. So, let's go make some money.
Just for you, Josh, it's 368 light years from Sol.
368 light years from Sol. Thank you very much. And 239 from Meene, where you actually get the missions from. So, you don't need a crazy exploration ship to actually get there. You just need a little bit of patience. If you do have an exploration ship, you could do it in about 10 jumps.
Oh, and 524 from Maya. Hmm. Interesting. I'm a bit disappointed that the core 70 sector is still locked.
Well, don't be disappointed. We're gonna see some stuff coming up here. You know we will.
Alien bubble.
You know it's coming.
If it's unlocked and you find that there's absolutely nothing there, then you can be disappointed.
Exactly. Yeah. They unlock it and it's like, hey, it's just another system.
Oh, by the way, nothing's here. We locked it for shits and giggles.
Why would that not surprise me? Right?
I don't know.
I mean, they do it just so we could throw some tinfoil on our heads. I mean, Shibuka has a great theory when he was working all of that stuff out. He was like, coal 70 sector's up here, this sector's down here, you come from here. It was like the whole Exodus theory that we were talking about in one of our broadcasts quite a ways back. That was interesting. He had he thought he connected the dots because of the lock system. You never know, he could be right.
I mean, a lot of people are still saying it's like the alien bubble, and might be right. It would be fun.
Could be, right? But
and it's very close to the entire Pleiades shenanigans that's going on right now. The aliens.
Yeah, it's true. It is pretty close.
And it has the Witch Head Nebula, and Barnard's Loop, and the Orion Nebula there.
I'm not POTUS, asks, is this mission rewarded to only the first one to finish? No, it's not. It's for anyone who completes the mission.
It's for anyone who has the patience for going through every single possible combination.
I don't know if it's so much the patience. I mean, if just like anything else in this game that is going to have a big payout, there's a little bit of a grind to it. So it's just a bit of a grind. That's all.
Yeah, but next to the grind, there is the server crashing, constant game crashes, disconnects, relogs.
Well,
sometimes the game even saying fuck you and not giving you any data.
I don't have too much trouble with that. It sounds like you might need to upgrade your cardboard box to like full on gaming PC.
Good joke, mate. I'm playing The Witcher 3 with the HD Modern Ultra. Good joke.
Well, maybe it's, I don't know. I don't know why you're crashing so much. It can't be
Everyone's
just the room.
Crashing.
Everyone's crashing?
Yeah.
Oh, I never had any problems with the ruins. We'll find out. Maybe they made some changes. Maybe that's the problem.
And maybe they made some crashes happen.
They put the crashes in there just for flavor. Skyrish is asking, can I get an invite to the server? You can go ahead and request an invite, and I can go ahead and accept you into the private group. It is the J. Hawkins private group. If you are just joining in on the live stream right now, welcome to the live stream. My name is Commander Josh Hawkins, and I'm joined by General Ghost, who...
Hello!
Yeah, there
who's
he is.
Not used to being introduced.
Yeah, that's right. Because last time we kind of ignored him, and Turgeon Starstone.
Kind of.
Hello, chat people.
Hey, there's Turgeon. You're watching the live stream. This is the how to make 100 million credits, and actually it's a typo. It's more like how to make 100 million and, well, 181 million credits.
Not entirely sure how many valid combinations there are.
There's going to be quite a few.
How many of you have seen Ghost? Because, I mean, I know that the Civilization one, because I picked up one of those.
Holy
historical
crap.
One, rather. It's 21 for that one. So how many of the others are there?
There are two with 21s, one with 19 and one with 20. It comes out to 81.
So
it's 181 million if you manage to complete it.
Yeah.
Plus, a carton of lore to write into a PDF file and upload it somewhere so everyone can read it.
Oh, thank you very much, League of Bell, for the donation. It says, keep up the good work. Had a warm welcome in your Discord today. It was nice. Keep up the good work. Only just found you from Obsidian Ant, but I binged watched all your YouTube videos today at work. Well, thank you very much. That's awesome. I'm glad you enjoyed them. And You know, where there is more coming. I don't know if you were watching the Exploring the Milky Way Galaxy series. I'll just throw it a quick mention to this.
That one is going to get finished.
There was a slight, well, it took a little slight. Break from it. Slight.
It's even longer than the rate that mine have come.
There was a few months of break there. But
I was sort of putting out one a week, and then it was a fortnight, it stayed a fortnight, and it's currently a month, I think, since the last one I put out.
I will say that, you know, those episodes take a considerable amount of time to make, and with the live streams and all the other videos that I put out, it started getting more and more difficult.
That was a hawk!
I just missed the hawk. I didn't see who actually subbed, darn. But
Turgeon...
Mini Durf. Do you want the crush one again? I'll have the crush.
Yeah, let's have the crush.
That's proper nasty.
That's proper nasty. thanks for the sub and welcome to the Hawk Flock. What was I saying? Right, the series. So they take me about 4 or 5 days to make one of those videos, and it's a lot of writing, a lot of recording, a lot of editing, and I think when I first started off, there's another hawk there. Darn it, I keep missing it. I gotta look down on the stream here. Hang on, let me just catch the name, and then we'll get back into what I was saying.
Well, while you're looking for that,
choppity chop chop, Mr. Hawk.
Danica has joined the Hawk Flock. Thank you very much, Danica, and welcome to the Hawk Flock. When I first started the YouTube channel, that was the only thing I was doing was the series. I didn't really expect to have such a great reception from the community, but people really liked it, and I started getting a lot of subs, and I kept pushing the series forward, and
it started out like a sort of National Geographic Discovery Channel type thing, didn't it? That's what I thought. I made a comment about it. Actually.
Yeah, that's right.
I said, if Discovery Channel is there in 3302, this will be on it, I said.
It was, because I didn't have a story at that point. Like, when it first started off, there's a Rebel by Choice has joined the Hawk Flock as well. Hey, thanks for the sub. Yeah. The heck was that?
So many balls.
Was that someone screaming in my house?
Mr. Hawk. Nom nom, tastes like chicken.
I don't know if that was someone screaming in my house or if one of my dogs just fell down the stairs. Hang on one sec. Puppies.
One of your dogs fell down the stairs.
Come here, Yoda, Padme. Come here.
Where is Luke?
Luke's not born yet.
Come here. Yeah, I hear you. Come on over.
Okay, no, they're both alive. I don't know what they're yelping about.
That's a good story.
Come here. Padme, come here. Come here, sweetie pie. Who's going to come first? We'll put you on camera.
Come on.
Yoda?
The first dog to arrive gets the camera shot.
Come here, you. All right, let's say hello. Here's Yoda. He's the fat one. Hold on. Relax, pal. Relax. Okay. Oh, big fat dog. There you are.
That's big.
There's Yoda. Hi, buddy. We can't see your eyes. There, you got eyes under there. What do you know? Hi.
His breath smells like tuna, too. Or like sardines.
Padme, come here.
And here's the little one. Here's the little one. Hi, sweetie pie. Okay, yes. Good girl. Okay, you guys are both alive and kicking. And now they're gonna knock over my green screen. Okay, so the series, right? It started off as a kind of a documentary. It was more like the Elite Dangerous documentary. I wanted to sort of introduce people to a little bit of space science, since Elite does such a great job at giving you that type of environment. But as I started getting a few episodes in, I realized that although it's really cool to jump around in space and show off planets and stuff,
it was very limited in terms of what you could actually show. Okay, you had black holes, you had stars, you had planets, you had some nebula, and that was about it. Well, there was neutron stars too, but they were kind of boring, especially to show off in the early days when Elite first came out. Neutron star was just looked like a star off in the distance because there was nothing to it. Same thing with the white dwarfs. Now, obviously, they're much better, but once I started getting a few episodes in, I'd done some history of the Elite Dangerous lore.
Might need to scoop there, Josh.
Oh, yeah, it's probably a good idea.
You are on the highway to hell with the brown dwarfs.
I'm only one jump away. I'm fine. But thanks for noticing that my fuel was running a bit low there. I wasn't really paying attention. After
that would be a first, wouldn't it?
No, right? <afraid.
laughs> Oh my! Hey, Dorje, check the comments.
Oh, thanks for pointing that out. Anyhow, I started realizing that story might be in order, and my wife said, "You gotta add a bit more emotion in there. Don't just make it like a documentary. You gotta actually have like something that people are gonna get excited about." So, I had an idea for a story.
You need a monotone voice.
What's that?
You need a monotone voice. Hey, Cookie Rebo just did a mission, and I got one of the data for it.
Hey, there you
Thanks,
go.
Thanks, Cookie Rebo.
So the story kind of originated when I found a crashed escape pod on a planet surface, and went from there, and it became very involved. It was a really fun story to create, because it almost felt like the story evolved around my writing.
I think this is the one you want.
What one do I want?
The one you want to read.
Oh, you found
it's
it.
About...
Okay, perfect.
I think Cookie Rebel might just found the time going to upload it.
Yeah, and I'm gonna accept a couple invites into the private group as well. There we go. Oh, there's a whole bunch. Accept. You guys can all come on, join in here. Hopefully nobody's looking to stream snipe. I mean, we've never had that problem in the past before. In fact, we have a really great community on my live streams.
Only with you and Shibuka trying to blow each other up.
Yeah, I mean, that's it. Shibuka's pretty much that's the only fair. One who tries to blow us up. I mean, we do have a lot of... blow me up, rather. We've got quite a bit of people in the private group now.
Quite a lot.
Oh, yeah, he does that, too.
He's pretty good at that.
I mean, even in the chat, we never really have any problems with that. We have a really great group of folks, very mature. In fact, it's really wonderful to do the live streams. I enjoy them very much because the people that are in here are really damn cool. I mean, what can I say? You guys are all awesome, and I really appreciate you guys supporting the channel and being a part of it and tuning in for these
very
live
mature,
streams.
Very mature, he says, overlooking last week's broadcast.
If you missed the broadcast on Sunday, and if you do happen to be new to this live stream, well, we do a live stream every Sunday called the broadcast. Turgeon's one of the co-hosts, and we have a couple other co-hosts as well, Shibuka and Grey Test. And that one can get a little silly.
A little.
Maybe
that one certainly did.
Just a tiny little bit silly. But it's fun. It's
the laughter was strong in that one.
the laughter was strong in the last one. I would strongly suggest if you're looking for a good chuckle and you want to watch some Elite Dangerous gameplay, go watch the last broadcast that's uploaded on my YouTube channel. And just be prepared. Be prepared. Not gonna lie, it was a little silly. It was a little foolish, and we had a lot of fun. But shenanigans were had. All right, I'm gonna get down on your wing signal here.
I think Tukirabo just confirmed one of my greatest fears, that there are possibilities that you need two urns or two orbs to unlock some of them.
Ooh. Yeah.
That's even more possibilities.
Well, we don't know because it's all RNG, so we're gonna have to mess around with this a little bit and figure it out. I'm coming down on the alien runes right now. So, for any of you who have not actually seen the alien runes, well, let's take a look.
Well, we have a few commanders over here already. Wow.
Down on the planet?
Take a look. Yeah. We have Cookie Rebel here. Commander Daniel. And that's all, I think. Oh no, there is a third one. Josh Lumares.
Another Josh. We got Joshua Ruskoff as well. Well, he's not here, but part of the group, I mean, the private group.
Oh yeah, and Cookie Rebel is hostile for me because he attacked me. With his fighter.
Shame on you, Cookie Rebel. Shame on you. Anyhow, just to wrap up what I was saying about the Exploring the Milky Way Galaxy series.
Yeah, mildly sidetracked there.
Yeah, mildly sidetracked, and another eagle just screamed, another hawk just screamed there, so we'll have to take a look at that name in just a second.
I'm not going to do anything for that. Carry on, you're being sidetracked.
Okay. Yeah, I am getting sidetracked. just gonna see the name that pops up. It was Depet NL has joined the Hawk Vlog, so thank you very much for the sub and welcome to the Hawk Vlog. And wrapping up very quickly on the series, it turned into 18 episodes, all of which, like I said, take roughly a week each to make, and it's a hell of a lot of work. But it is going to be continued. Part 19 is already partially completed. I mean, most of the video is filmed for it, and we're just missing a little bit of the voice recordings need to be done, but we're waiting on one particular person. And once that's done, part 19 will be coming out. And once part 19 is done, the rest of the series can sort of get back to its usual status. This one particular episode has kind of been holding me up for.
Mine's kind of the same at the moment, waiting for voices.
Yeah, it was more for creative reasons.
There was, wasn't there? Yeah.
There was. It was. It had sort of gotten to the point where.
Oh, sorry.
I know what the story. Well, what was supposed to happen in the episode, and I had filmed. Believe it or not, I've had this filmed since the beta of Horizons. That's how long ago we got the footage, and I remember the reason why we did it in the beta was because I wanted to get the tire tracks from the SRVs,
I had to scrap a lot of my old footage when we got.
How long ago was the beta for Horizons? Like a year ago?
It was a long time. Mike.
So I've had the footage for a year, and that was footage in preparation for part 19. And that's how it went. And so it will be done soon. And if you are looking forward to part 19, expect it soon, TM.
And there is the wild Josh Hawkins.
So look at this. So it does look different, so, doesn't it?
Well, I think you should get an aerial view to see how different it is.
I saw coming in how different it looked, and it's sort of weird that it looks so entirely different than how it looked originally. I'm trying to figure out why they would do that.
I don't know.
Why?
Draw attention to it?
Well, do you know, if I was a cynical person at all, people that know me, I would say that it's because they weren't expecting the ruins as we found them to be found as soon as we did find them. So some of the stuff there was kind of placeholder. So what we're looking at here is what the ruins should have been when we first found them. That's my guess.
That's a good guess. It is considerably different, though. I mean, like, this is... It doesn't even look like
they've moved things
place.
Around to make it more accessible. They've moved all the filing cabinets around to make them in different places. And we can't find totems anymore.
Well,
if anyone's got an alien totem, hang on to it, because they don't exist anymore.
They exist, just we can't find them. We are playing Blindkins right now.
Blindkins?
Yeah. Just Blindkins.
Just going to take a look at the chat real quick here. Let's see what's going on. I see quite a bit of chat going on. So there's a post on Reddit claiming the layout of the ruins changed. Yeah, well, that's exactly what we're saying here, Sam. So we can confirm that they have. We were one of the first people to be here, as a matter of fact. In fact, I think I was the first person to put out a video on the ruins, if I'm not mistaken.
I
had a really good close look at what these ruins look like. I spent a considerable amount of time here. I was like... hours.
Yeah, we spent ages driving around and destroying things and going, oh, no, what's he done? He's blown that up. No.
Putting my debug camera underground and looking at the little spinning things under there. Like, there was all kinds of stuff to be seen and to video. Chris Bennett saying there's only 27 combination of relics with doubles and singles. 27 combination of relics, but you have to scan the data banks here, these obelisks.
Each and every one of them with
different combinations, and there's quite a few of those. So that's going to make it so that there's that's how you do it. Craig Meister. So how do you make the 100 billion million gazillion credits? Well, we're at the site right now, Craig Meister. So we're going to actually show how that works. Oh, Joshua Ruskoff is here in spirit. Thanks, Joshua. Thanks for popping in spirit. You must scan all the things. Yes, exactly. Don Branham, by the way, I just want to give a quick shout out. Don has...
Oh my god.
Hold on. Don has been really awesome.
Oh, you've got found a totem. Where?
Okay, so Don has...
Where is it roughly?
The totem's not going anywhere. It's not going anywhere.
It's behind the triangles.
Behind the triangles. Wonderful.
Yeah, 8.
Okay.
That is my sheep.
So I just want to give credit to Don, because Don is who tweeted out to me and let me know, number one, about the alien encounter on Twitter. He messaged me on that, and then he messaged me about this again today. Now, I already knew about this, but I appreciate the heads up anyhow, Don. Makes it very, very... Well, I really appreciate when people send me messages and let me know that stuff is going on in the game. So if you want to add me on Twitter or on Facebook and you find something that's really cool and you'd like to see an interesting video on it, you message me. I will make sure that a video gets done and posted. So I guess you guys all have Don to thank, in a sense, for the alien videos, because if I hadn't have got his tweet, I would not have rushed home and put that video together as quickly as I did. So thank you very much, Don, and also thank you very much for joining into the live stream today and taking a part in this.
So for third gen, it's at my picture, like the one I use for categorizing, the triangle which has obelisk number 7, and it's to southeast of that in that little crevice area.
All right.
But, like, over here you could see in stream. So it was right here where I stand.
Okay. Oh, don't flip over. Oh, I think this is where it is, right here.
Here, where I am right now, you know, the blue dot.
That's the casket.
It was here, I already have it in my inventory.
Oh, I see. Right over here.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I'll go ahead and grab the casket, just so that I have two of these on me.
Yeah, and you might need to re-log into Lysol or something to scan the ruin sites, because people might want to scan them.
Alright, well, now I have two of these things here, and now we're going to go start scanning some runes. This is how you actually get...
Okay, if you come over here, there are still unscanned ones where I am right now.
If you scan them, can I no longer scan them? Is that how it works?
Yeah, I think.
What?
Yeah.
That's crazy. Crazy.
These horrors is still scannable. And we can test it out while we are here, too.
A hero has joined the Hawk Flock. Thank you very much for the sub, A hero, and welcome to the Hawk Flock. Let's see if we can go scan some of these runes and see how they
say
work.
Hello to my little friend.
You guys have Turgeon to thank for the awesome soundboard effects, by the way. He is kind of our unofficial or blame, yeah. He's like our unofficial sound guy. Well,
let me see if I get lucky.
Unofficial slash official sound guy.
It, as far as anything in the pro bar, anything counts as official.
Yeah, that's it.
Nothing.
Now, none of these are popping up for me, so...
Come over here, Josh. There are three of them here that you can scan.
Hold on. Can I scan this one? Yeah, I should be able to.
Now link to my mission message.
Okay, so these are the things that you need to scan right here. Oh, no, wrong button. There we go. So I can scan this one. Active ancient obelisk and pattern alpha obelisk data. Let's see
and
if that
you
actually
should get
works.
A message.
Decoding the ancient runes, decoded ancient historical data. Yeah, there we go. So 8 of 21.
Which one?
I got 8 of 21 right over where I am. So decoded ancient data historical research, 8 of 21. This data contains details regarding the rise of new technologies. It appears that the development of these technologies varied between clans, creating inequality and ultimately conflict. Initially, that conflict was resolved through personal combat between individual champions. But as clans started using numbers to overwhelm their opponents, the practice of warfare began to spread. This led to a surge in weapons development, with biological warfare quickly established as the weapon of choice. An arms race began, focused on the development of biological agents and various countermeasures. It saddens me to discover this, as I had hoped the Guardians would prove to be more advanced. A little naive, I know, as conflict is a common element of many species through the galaxy. Whether for resources, land, power, over others, we all seem to share this shame. That's true. I mean, okay. It's hard to... hang on, what's he saying? Please forgive my intrusion, Commander. According to a subroutine...
I scanned it, because it seems you can scan them independently now.
Oh, it says some appear to require two objects in your hold to decode, while others require a single object.
The right combination. Talking about getting the right combination for everything.
Okay, so that's very interesting. It means that obviously. Oh, I
and
just,
it gets
just
a bit
got another
bored
one.
After every single time hearing that.
Oh, okay, so as long as someone else is doing it, I still get the data as well, because I just got number 12 as well.
I didn't get it.
Well, let's read out number 12. It says, this data is incredible. The information regarding the Guardians' first attempts at space travel are particularly interesting. Although the Guardians clearly had the capacity for sophisticated flight technology, they had not built anything more advanced than dirigibles?
Dirigibles.
What's a dirigible?
An airship to you, sir.
Yeah, an airship.
Like the Hindenburg.
Yeah, it later says it's an airship.
Okay. No like doubt, like because airships were more in keeping with their ecologically conscientious philosophy. With rocket technology deemed unenvironmentally friendly, they developed vast launchers that used electromagnetic propulsion to catapult ships into space. Breathable gel cocoons helped pilots and passengers withstand the huge G-forces. Very cool. Experienced on launch. And served as hibernation pods during long journeys. Having not yet developed faster-than-light technology, the Guardians constructed three large arcs for their first interstellar colonies, much like the generation ships in our own history. This is really cool stuff, guys. It's
rail guns with pillows. Nice.
Yeah, right?
And I might ask for my own research for anyone who's here at the ruins and discover something. Could you please put it in the chat to which obelisk and which combination according to like the map?
Here's another one. Let's see if I can scan this one as well.
Because it would be great to speed things up a bit. Still have to get every single one of them.
Yeah, we got another one here as well. And there's another hawk scream. I'll see what the name is in just a sec when that pops up. Let's see which one we got here. No. That's already done. I gotta delete them as they pop up so I don't end up going over the exact same ones again.
Screenshot them.
Hold on, I'm just waiting for the name to pop up on my video. Did I miss it? I don't see the name popping up.
Oh, people are talking about stream acting up again.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Like it was till the night.
Really?
It looks okay on mine. If anyone's having trouble with the stream, just exit and reload the page or come back in. YouTube was having some trouble the other day. And we had some issues when I was live streaming for the alien discovery.
Yeah.
was a bit of a pain in the butt. The whole thing kept freezing up. It was fine for most people and not for others. So if you have any problems with the stream, just refresh the page or pop back in here. If you do see people hopping off their church, and you want to just let me know just so I can say goodbye as well. Rogue is taken off, I guess. Rogue 949,
yep,
take it easy, bud. Thanks for joining in on the stream, Rogue.
And connection error.
Okay, so what did I get here? Let's see. So this one I'm going to delete. This one I'm going to delete.
It's curious because the first two that I found here in order was historical data 821 and then 1221, which is... Well, it's the same two that you found.
It is the same two. Okay, so let's just duplicate.
Actually, it might not actually matter what you get, just that you found a right combination, and then it spits them out in the same order regardless.
It could be. So I don't know who it was that just hit the sub button. Apologize, the name somehow skipped out because the YouTube stream was acting a little funny for me. But thanks for the sub. Welcome to the Hawk Flock. And normally,
Turgeon's... Hey, Hawk.
Yeah, there you
subscribe
go.
Subscribe this.
Had log back and it's fine now. YouTube streaming is bugged, says Renato Moo. Yeah, it's, sometimes YouTube can be a little bit funny. Barry Dillard, you're asking what planet we're on. We are in the Sinufe XR-HD11-102 system. These are the ancient alien ruins. So basically what you have to do here, folks, is you got to make your way over to here after getting the mission update from the Meene system. You can land at any station in the Meene system, and this fine gentleman there gives us the mission to come over to the ancient alien ruins, and he tells us that he's found a way to decode these things, which, if you've never seen these before, by the way, if this is the first time you're seeing the ruins, well, it's a pretty awesome thing to behold. It's one of a kind right now in Elite. There are no other places like this that we know of yet, which I'm sure that with all this information that we're getting, we probably will see more alien runes appear at some point. I'm hoping that some of this stuff is going to lead us to...
I don't want to say one thing.
You don't want to say one thing?
Something about data mining, blah blah blah.
Oh, okay. Well, we don't talk about data mining.
We don't want to say that, but
no,
you know,
no,
it's
we're just not gonna say it. Yeah, blah blah blah. Exactly. Data mining is where we stop. We don't data mine.
No one should go.
Yeah, we
that's
don't.
That's like the worst.
We don't data mine. I know some people like to do that stuff, but whatever people data mine, we don't talk about it in the bro bar or on my streams, because I'm not interested.
Yeah.
I don't like spoilers.
I'm not interested in it either, but it just saddens me that people do it.
Yeah, it is a little sad that people do it. I mean, but what can you do,
it's
right?
Opening Christmas presents. I mean, come on. What's the point?
No point.
Why bother?
None whatsoever. Huh. How come... What happened to my thing, Majigabobbers? My SRV
Which
cargo
one?
Is showing as empty.
Oh, it will. Just change the tab thing, and then change back, and it'll show up.
What?
No.
I thought they'd fix that, but they haven't. On the right panel, when you know, go to inventory, just change to something else, like materials or cargo, and then swap back.
That's what I did. Still shows.
And if you are carrying something, it should show.
Well, I am. I see it says capacity 2 of 2 in there, but I don't actually see what I'm holding.
Yeah, it's yet another one of these little bugs that they should have fixed, but...
Frontier fixing bugs. Fixed stream RV in the dream stream.
Well, the problem with this is that I want to scan this obelisk. Well, I did just scan the obelisk. Of course, now it's disappeared, so you don't know if I actually had the right combination of thingamajiggy-bobbers in there, because it just vanished off the screen, which is, I guess... somewhat unfortunate, because it could have given me some kind of data.
Wait,
there.
What? Okay, something's changed here.
Let's take a look at something. If I go to
this
now...
This is the one that's supposed to... What?
Okay, so for each one that you scan, you make 1,000,000 credits, which is actually not bad.
Each one that you scan and you get data out of, like, research data.
Yeah, each one that you scan and you get data, you get 1,000,000 credits, and then you get 100,000,000 credit bonus for getting all 20-something of them, right?
Yeah.
Well, it says 20 something.
I want to know how he knows that there are that many. He's scared.
Because I have
guy.
One of each category now.
That's a good question.
I mean, how does he know?
Yeah,
how
not you. How did the guy know? Well, we're gonna get more data.
Well, he's a fucking AI.
That's he scares me.
He's the AI we're looking for.
This is the AI you're looking for.
Yeah.
All right, let's scan this one over here and see what we get.
He's what, elite bishop, is he?
Oh, ancient alien civilization data. There we go.
Which one?
I don't know. I just got a message from Ram Tah saying, please forgive my intrusion. Another, according to the subroutine in my code, this is not a valid combination.
Yeah, I'm scanning. That's why might be.
You know, they shouldn't even bother with that frontier. They should have just made that, like...
One time only, and then
just go,
never...
When you get the wrong combination, and that way you go, oh, wrong combination. They shouldn't give you an incoming mission critical. You go, ooh, and then you look and it's rubbish. And you think, well, that's not very critical. Why couldn't it just go,
Looks like the stream is doing a funny thing again on mine. Oh, it just stalled for a second. Let's see. Here's another one. Again, wrong combination. Okay, so this one's wrong combination. This one's wrong combination.
This is a gigantic puzzle. If you want
it. I'm just going to reload my own stream because it's a little funky for me right now.
Ramtar's just a lazy git, I think. He knows there's like a billion combinations out here and he just can't be asked to do it, so he's just sent us out.
Yep. Okay, so just a heads up, folks. The YouTube stream is doing what it was doing the other day again. I don't know why it's doing this. It's, damn YouTube is just ruining my streams. I've already lost like 50 people watching. It's dropped down to 108 from 150.
Okay.
Well.
So, I'll finish it.
It's a bit of a pain in the ass. I hope you guys stick it out with me here. Now it's dropped down to 88 people watching, so... Way to go, ruining my streams, YouTube! Thanks a lot, Google!
Yeah.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, if you do stick around, apologize for the stream issues. Once again, YouTube has decided to screw around with everything that I do when I'm streaming. I'm very seriously considering streaming on Twitch because of these stupid problems.
Might be better.
It might be better. I mean, I don't know why it keeps doing this. It's such a pain in the ass. I've never had problems with YouTube and streaming before. It's always worked fine until this week. It started on Friday and it's been going on for the past few days. Actually, no, the broadcast we didn't have any problems at all. There was no streaming issues.
No, we didn't. That was fine.
I don't know, it's just like certain times of the day or something. I don't know what the hell it's all about.
I might say that it's me that I'm doing it, but I was on that broadcast too and it had no problems.
Nope. No, it's just somewhat random, really. Sometimes YouTube just flakes out. It's just when it flakes out, it people end up leaving the stream because they don't want to watch a screen that's frozen. And it's not on my end, it's damn YouTube.
They will rewatch it afterwards.
Yeah, well, if they reload it. If you're watching the stream and it starts freezing up for you, just bear with it. If you're having fun and you're enjoying watching the stream, you know, we encourage you to stick around. Obviously, I don't want anyone to have to stare at a frozen screen for too long, and if it's bugging out too much, I apologize.
By the way, Josh, something is wrong for me. The wrong obelisks are active. Completely wrong ones.
The wrong obelisks? Wow, I don't know what you mean by that.
I don't know, it looked then like completely wrong obelisks are up. Like on the other side of the data bank or something, yeah, right here.
Oh, here's one over here I see glowing.
Oh, there you are. Josh, for you the normal ones, but for me, this... Ah! No, I'm not showing you. Connection error.
There. Got one right over here. Let's see if we can do this.
Let's begin back
You know what I want to do? I want to get into my my inventory and drop one of these out, but I can't see my darn inventory. Okay, I'm gonna re-log my my Elite Dangerous client, because it's acting kind of funny. I'll just wait the 15 seconds. I'll re-chat in the meantime.
Like now everything.
It freezes for 30 seconds and then works for 3 seconds. Yeah, I know, Sam. I don't know what the heck is going on with that. It's just YouTube. It'll fix itself eventually. So.
Now it's working for me perfectly, but it might be just me.
I'm just going to restart my client and go back into the private group. There we go.
Say that I'm going to quit and watch your continue watching your stream.
Evan Robertson says, how much time do you get to complete the mission? You have 4 weeks to complete the mission. DH397, I completely understand, man. Thanks a lot for joining in and being a part of the stream. You have a good night as well. Dr.
Yes,
Evil.
You guys can rewatch it.
Dr. Evil is more than worth the trouble. $100 million? Have we done the Ord and combo yet? Is that like a Skyrim reference?
No, that's Diablo 2.
Oh. Orb and Urne.
Diablo 2.
If anybody finds a Zod here, then
oh
that's
my
fine. Stick
God.
That in your ship. Do you remember?
I completely forgot about...
I can see that it takes forever for
you. Do you remember the classic image of an indestructible rune stuck in a bow which don't degrade? You remember that one?
vaguely.
Bows which didn't degrade anyway in Diablo 2, and someone had stuck a Zod rune.
Maddie, I will invite you to the group as soon as the game decides it wants to load in. We're staring at the loading screen right now, but it's not actually loading in.
Elite is acting funny now with the new update. And my Steam is acting funny too, because it thinks Elite is still running. What the hell?
Uh-oh. Oh, look at that! Okay, well, I just got a crash on Elite Dangerous after that extremely long load.
Oh!
So...
Yeah, the game is acting up.
The game is acting up. Well, let's see what happens here. I'll see if I can get back in. That was weird. I've never had Elite Dangerous crash on me ever in 3 years. Not one single crash.
And today it crashed a dozen of times.
Yep.
The
game trial says
instant drops, but not a crash. No, I've never seen a crash in games.
The game trials is saying the Thargoids have intercepted YouTube servers. I think they've intercepted everything. They've intercepted the YouTube servers and they've intercepted the client.
I saw you making the video and like, let's fuck with this guy.
Probably.
They hate you.
Hey, General Ghost, let's keep the F-bombs to a minimum. It's a family-friendly channel.
like last one. Right?
Exactly.
It was still family friendly.
It is still family friendly.
A slightly dysfunctional.
And actually, family. The F-bomb is still family friendly.
He was saying.
Didn't actually swear.
He was saying fuck, which is a seal fuck. In French.
Yeah.
For anyone who's seen that Family Guy video, the best.
I'm saying the Hungarian word for tree and multiple trees.
Oh, is that what it is? The Hungarian word for tree?
No, the Hungarian word for tree is fa.
Hang on,
and fuck the fuck. It's like more trees and fuck multiple trees.
All right, so we're talking about
I
a forest in Hungarian. Okay, well,
That's a different word.
Now I'm having all kinds of stuff crash. My Stream Warrior just crashed, and I think Elite Dangerous is frozen again. Oh no, Elite Dangerous is working. Okay, I don't know why Warrior just crashed. Oh, that was weird.
Well, we only have like 24 minutes till 3 a.m. for the 2 hour mark.
That was weird. Elite Dangerous crashed. Now Stream Warrior crashed. Let's get this back up and running.
Maybe you should watch pretty cat pictures. Maybe that would calm down the gods.
You want me to put on some cat pictures? Yeah, we could do that.
Maybe that would calm down the gods that has turned against us.
Let's see if we can get back into the game. Maybe Possibly. Giovanni says, Foca, Foca in Spanish. family-friendly Cookie Rebel? Yes. He's like, quote, 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 family-friendly.
It's dysfunctional family.
Functional. Yeah, I mean, listen.
Functional family can take a joke.
My daughter is 16 years old, and although I don't necessarily like her swearing her head off, I tell her to keep it to a minimum. I said, there's certain people that you can and you can't swear around, okay? And I mean, I don't care if people swear as long as they're not just like GDMFNBN FFFFFMR fucking, you know, like that just like that's enough. I don't need people around me who are going to talk like that. It's just not necessary. I never talk like that. My mom would have slapped the face right off me if I did.
Sometimes you just need to
in fact,
those words out.
Funny story. I grew up in a household where swearing was like, no, you don't swear. I never heard my parents swear. And of course, you know, I was a regular kid. As soon as I was out of the house, I was swearing my ass off. one day I'm in the schoolyard in elementary school. I was like, I don't know, 10, 11 years old. And I'm just standing there and someone comes and puts their hands over my eyes. And I thought it was my buddy. And I'm like, oh, Mark, would you F off? And the hands come off my eyes and I hear like a gasp, like, and I turn around and it's my mom standing right there, just looking at me with like this pale face, like, oh my God, my son just said the F word. And I must have turned white as a ghost. I swear to God. I was like, oh my God, sorry, mom, I thought it was my friend Mark.
What have I done?
What have I done?
You anger the gods.
And of course, you know, I went home and that story very quickly went to my father, who found out that I had swore to my mother.
So, yeah. And the domino falls.
Yeah, you know what they say, shit rolls downhill. So I was at the bottom of the hill that day.
Shite draws down.
Very bottom of the hill. Yeah. Here's a few more private group accepts. If anyone wants to join in.
Until you can do it.
Yeah, well I can. Now let's see if I can see my inventory. No, I can't. What do you know?
Maybe jump back into your ship.
Why? Why is it not visible?
Yeah, no.
Oh, it's my God, what a pain in the a-hole. Well, okay, I'm going to go back to my ship.
YouTube has ruined two streams.
Well, the stream's running. It's working now, right?
Okay, this one was ruined by Frontier. I take that.
Yeah. Let's go back in the ship and see if this makes any difference.
Yeah.
Stupid.
Can always try.
Come on, there we go. Transfer cargo. Oh yeah. Well, you can see it, can't you? You can. Get back into my inventory. Well, you know what? Here.
Oops, you're stuck.
Oh, you broke the game. All right, let's go back now and oops, let's not spin out like crazy. All right, let's go back with just an orb this time. Maybe it was one of the things I was carrying that was messing it up. Who knows?
Yeah.
Thanks to anyone who has stuck around despite the YouTube woes once again today. Appreciate you guys.
Suddenly an
osp
appears.
A wild asp appears. Not mine.
This episode is so much Pokemon related, like catch all the Dotto.
Yeah, that's pretty much what it is, right? Oh, there's one. There's one right over here.
You should go back to the four pillars because there is one in the top side.
Jiggums in chat says, show me how to make money in 3 minutes or effing leaving. I think you should just look over to your left panel in the cockpit and show money and money acquired already from scan. That would show him.
Stream.
Oh, here we go.
A little.
Is that the? Yeah, here we go. I got another one. 7 of 20. Okay, you want to see how to make money?
Yeah, that's how you make
This is how you make money, okay? So you grab that mission, you come over here, and you get this stuff. Decoded ancient data technology research.
Yeah,
7 of 20.
I have that one already.
So this is very interesting. According to the data package you just sent me, they monolith network was used for most, if not all, communications regardless of importance. In keeping with their prediction for sharing knowledge, few restrictions were placed on the network. I thought there might have been separate networks for military and administrative use, but I haven't found any evidence of that. Everything points to an extremely open society, which would have made them even more vulnerable when significant social divisions arose. And I'm going to agree with that, because now I want to read General Ghost's other one that you found. Did you PM it to me in Discord?
Well, I have the RAW file still sent to you.
The one that I wanted there, the one about the genders. Is that in here as well?
Here it is.
Okay, so it's very true. It's a very open society. Here's a 7 of 19. Wow, that's weird. Yeah. How come that one's 7 of 19?
And... because the biological has 19.
Oh, so technology has 20, biological is 19. Okay, so there are quite a few then.
History has 21 and language has 21.
I see. So there are many of these. Okay, so let's go back to this one then. So this one says... decoded ancient data biology research. This data offers more details about the physical appearance of the Guardians, specifically regarding genders. The similarities between humans and the Guardians continues to delight me. They had two distinct genders and reproduced sexually. There don't appear to have been any taboos surrounding sexual activity, as the data contains a large quantity of graphic images and recordings. Not unlike some of our data nets. So this is what I'm saying. Like, the biological version or the biological ones are basically just a giant porn hub.
Yep. Space porn, everybody. Alien space porn.
Alien space porn. That is how we're making money in Elite Dangerous now, is through alien space porn. And no, I was not the fluffer for those videos. Just clarifying, okay? Just to make sure that everyone understands that is not what I do. All right, I found another one over here. Let's go scan this one and see if we can get any more alien porn with no taboos too. So I mean, that was like an alien on alien, alien on human, female on female aliens, male on male, and everything in between. Good old no taboo alien biological sex. All right, we got another one, gamma and alpha. What's this one? Oh, another technological. Yep, here we go. This data, while unremarkable at first glance, has proven something that I long suspected to be true. The networks were content agnostic, and the full range of language forms was supported. I've even found extracts of virtual entertainment experience that supported full audience participation. That's pretty cool. So by the way, if you're joining the stream and you're going, well, how do I make 100 million credits? We're in the process of doing that right now. And I'll just quickly recap. Which one?
This one, the 9 out of 20 technology. I don't have this one yet.
Okay, well, I'm going to just quickly recap for anyone who's joining in the stream or who's just fast-forwarded the stream after it's gone onto the YouTube channel recorded. We're doing... let me get back into my little menu over here. So I will show you what we're doing. We have this new contract, stop wiggling, SRV, Jesus, called Decoding the Ancient Ruins. As you can see right over here, the mission completion bonus is 100 million credits. I've already got 4 million credits because I've got 4 of the scan parts, and there's numerous different scan parts. So I have a feeling you're going to make about 80 million credits or so is what they've calculated before the bonus. So it's actually going to pay off about almost 200 million when you're done. The way you do that is you go to the Meene system, which is M-E-E-N-E, and you just dock at any of the stations there. Make sure before you dock that you get rid of, in your data, if you've already been to the Ancient Ruins, you get rid of any of the obelisk data that you've scanned already. Just dump it out of your inventory and then land at any of the runes, and you'll just get a message in your messages right up here, and it'll basically give you the mission to come back to the runes. And what you need to do is you need to go around and pick up the ancient items that are there, the orbs and the caskets and all of that, and then you take them around, and there's random combinations, nobody really knows what they are quite yet, but you just take them around, you bring them to these different obelisks, and you scan the obelisks, and if you have the right combination, you're going to get the data. Once you've completed it and you've gotten all the data, not only will you get an incredible amount of lore-rich background story, which is really cool because everything that I'm reading so far seems really interesting, and we're learning about the Guardians, which is another alien race, at least we think it is. You never know, maybe the Guardians spawned to the Thargoids. Maybe that's what we're going to find out. Wouldn't that be interesting? They created them. And you're also going to get a million credits for each one of these that you scan and get data from. Once you've got all of the different data sets, you get... Oh, that one was already accessed. Then you get a 100 million credit bonus. You have lots of time to do this, folks. There is no rush to get over here. I don't know how long the mission is going to be available, mind you, so that's something you might want to grab real quick, but you get 4 weeks to collect all of the data. And... I mean, you can come over here, grab a little bit, go back, do it another time. It doesn't all have to be done all at the exact same time. I'm going to grab as many as I can right now and make a few mil and probably finish this off on another play session. But the whole idea here is that...
I love your confidence. Finish this off.
I am a completionist, okay? I'm a completionist.
It'll only take me two goes, you know?
Yeah, just two. Two goes is all you need, right?
You know, 100 odd. 81 records with a combination of 6 artifacts, and you might need one, you might need two. Yeah, I'll dash that off.
Maybe one.
You might need two of the same one.
Might need two of the same one, even.
Yeah, sure. It'll be done real soon. Someone somewhere is going to make a walkthrough guide for this before I finish
you
it.
You can be sure of it. The stats, the number, folks, they will be...
Guide already, Josh. Pick up two things, scan everything.
Pick up the next two things.
Scan everything. Switch, scan everything. Pick up two new things, scan everything.
Someone's already working on that. You know that, I know that, so I'm not worried.
Yeah.
Yes, but still, oh, it's randomized what you get.
There's another client crash right there.
Oh, I wanted to ask you if you print screen the number 9.
No, I didn't print screen it. Okay, well, you know what? Here's what I'm going to do, just because, unfortunately, with the new patch and the instability of the server at the moment, I'm going to call the stream to its end.
Something needs to fix it.
YouTube is being a pain in the butt, and FDev is being a pain in my butt. And just looking right now, I see the stream is freezing as well. So let's go ahead... Let's go ahead and get everyone's salutes in there so I can say goodbye to everyone who has been so kind as to join in. And we'll continue this on another stream. I'm going to just type it out because I don't know if people can hear me.
Yeah, maybe before you eat the
are still challenge. In the stream, please put in your salute now. Oh, your salute now. Gonna call it because stream and client are both crashing. This will be back up there at a later date. So, everyone, thanks for joining in. Let's go through the list here. We've got, Commander Josh Hawkins. Thanks for joining, Commander Josh Hawkins. You're welcome! General Ghost, Valdarsh, Jacob Hayden, Commander Malik, Joshua Ruskoff, Giovanni, Maddie, Zarkazul, Grelster, Mark Patterson, David S., Molitar, Don Branham, and for those of you who have not put your salutes in, by the way, this is what I do at the end of all my streams. I like to get everyone to put the little salute symbol so we could say goodbye. Frogster, Molitar, Kung Young Wu, The Cookie Rebel, Andy K., Tyler Anderson, OXO7AF, Valeriano, Martino, X-Man 2008, Daniel, Sungirl, Zapload, The Right Nut, Alien Spore Bomb, Max Zarzewski, Zach Zarzewski, Todd RTM, Alien Spore Bomb, Olito, Backside Flip 91, Craig Chapman, YouTube Hero 3, Palago, Dark Chaos, Dan Fry, Evan Robertson, Josh Arnold, X-Men 2008. I think you already did that, X-Men. And by the way, if you are just joining in the stream, sorry we've come to an end, but we do appreciate you guys all joining in. And I'd like to say if you had fun, if you enjoyed the stream, please hit that like button. Don't forget to subscribe. I live stream on a regular basis, and we have lots of other YouTube videos that come up on my channel, different space games, Elite Dangerous and whatnot. Appreciate you guys being here. Thanks for the support. General Ghost, thank you very much for your wise words and guidance through the Alien Rune Collection.
And Alien Rune Collection.
Alien Rune Data Collection. And
you are saying rune instead of ruin. It's
ruin.
Funny.
And Turgeon, of course, thank you very much for your joining in and your wonderful audio editing, of course.
Always a pleasure.
I'm a real boy!
When's the next stream, Maddie? Probably going to be in a couple of days. So we'll have another stream coming up in a couple of days. I don't know if it's going to be Elite Dangerous. We'd actually probably stream something else, maybe some Astroneer, maybe some Space Engineers.
I think we already know what that stream is going to be about.
I'm going to jump back into the game and see if it crashes a little bit more. Everyone's welcome to play on the private group, of course. And Murica, says Molitar. Yes, only when Shibuka's here. So thanks so much, guys. Sorry about the freezing. YouTube's a pain in the butt, and so is FDev right now with the crashes. But let's all go check out patch 2.2.03, and make sure you hit that sub button so we get notifications next time we do a live stream. This is Commander Josh Hawkins, signing off.